and welcome to the PCMS Spring Band Concert. We'd like to take a moment to recognize any Princeton Board of Ed members, administrators, or other Princeton staff in the audience and thank them for coming. Please stand, give us a wave. Let's see where you are. How about any Princeton alumni? Do we have any proud alumni in the house? Let me see. Stand up, Vikings. Let's see ya. Awesome. We'd like to thank our auditorium manager tonight, Brandon Matthews, for our light and sound. Thank you, Mr. Matthews. We'd also like to thank the Princeton Music Boosters for everything they do to support music at Princeton with fundraising, advocacy, scholarships, and especially creating our printed program. Please note there are four exits in our auditorium, out the back left and right, both downstairs and in the balcony. Please keep the two aisleways clear as they are for performers to enter and exit the stage. Restrooms are located by the arena, but we request that you only enter and exit Matthews during applause or stage changes. Please help us keep our auditorium nice by keeping all food and drink in the lobby only. Out of respect for our performers, please refrain from all cell phone use unless you are capturing photo memories, in which case, please turn off the flash. All right, big exciting news. By the time you exit here tonight, Grandma's Goodies on the Go food truck will be out outside of Viking Village in case you'd like to get a treat for your very special performer tonight. And a portion of proceeds will benefit the Princeton Music Boosters, and it is a beautiful evening for an ice cream treat, so we hope that you will stand in line and get a goodie. All right, the sixth grade band members have been working hard, and we are very excited to share their progress with you tonight. Our first piece tonight will light up Matthews with dragon fire. We have knighted our students with the armor of subdivision and will attack the dreaded dotted quarter note. We hope you love this epic musical quest called The Dreaded, Devious, Diabolical, Dotted Dragon.
Thank you.
Our next piece features each section with melodic material and a rhythmic motif and helped us learn listening skills and independent counting. We hope you enjoy Nocturnal Dances. Before we play our final piece, I'd like to call attention to a few new instruments you see in your program and on the stage. Baritones and tubas, please stand and show off your new to you instruments. Right here. They've been learning those new instruments since about mid-March. And in addition, we have one student who has started bassoon lessons and will be playing bassoon in the 7th grade Zero Bell Concert Band. Justice, stand up. He's gonna be our new bassoon player. There are a lot of kids on this stage playing a lot of instruments, and I don't do this by myself. It takes a village, takes a team. And you do see Mr. Lenhart back there. He works with 6th grade band. behind you in the back, we have Mr. Phillips and Mrs. Hurley. And one of the things that we like best is the four of us will be still teaching your band kids when they are seniors in high school. So we call that vertical teaching, and we love that because we get to know them really well, we get to know you really well, and you get to know us really well, and that's just good for everybody. So, all right, our final piece. The instructions on our final piece tonight tell the musicians to play cool with sass and swagger. Need I say more? We think our band students are awesome sauce, and you will too when you hear this piece. I forgot, you get to help us with this piece. So, first thing we need to do is count to four out loud. Ready? Go. One, two, three, four. Good. Next, you're gonna snap on two and four. So, one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. All right, you got. Thank you.
Good evening.
There we go. Up in front of you now is the seventh grade band. And this group of students has worked extremely hard this year. They are small, but they are mighty. And they've done some pretty difficult music, and I'm very proud of each and every one of them. I couldn't do it without Mr. Lenhart, my assistant for Band 7, so let's give him a round of applause. And we are going to be playing three pieces for you tonight. The first one is called Brazil. The second one is titled Colliding Visions, and then we will end with a Spanish march called España Cani. So please welcome to the stage Mr. David Funky, recent graduate from Miami University.
Thank you.
All right, so our last piece, España Cani, is a well-known paso doble, which means double step, which is a type of Spanish march that is performed at bullfights, usually when the participants are entering the ring. So you can kind of imagine that as we play this. And this is a very tricky piece. I chose this piece to challenge the kids, and they really rose to that and have done a nice job with it. It is going to feature a trumpet duet with Ava and Hostin. So go ahead and wave. They know who you're listening to. All right. And they've worked really hard on that, too. So this is España Cani.
Thank you. Thank you for your patience. I appreciate that. On stage is Band 8. My name is Todd Linhart, director of Band 8, and I'd certainly like to recognize the assistant director for Band 8, Mrs. Kristen Brown. Let's give it up. And certainly I would like to offer a formal thank you to all of the members of the Pride of Princeton Marching Band that are joining us this evening in Band 8. Give them a big round of applause. Our first two selections, Korean Folk Rhapsody and Celebration and Song.
Thank you.
at the beginning of the year with Band 8, it was made very clear that our number one goal is to prepare the Band 8 members for full participation in the high school band program. I'm very pleased that we've accomplished that goal. All but two or three of the Band 8 members are continuing on with our high school band program and will be joining, as well as the eighth graders from Zero Bell Concert Band. In July, they'll be joining the one and only Pride of Princeton Marching Band. And I think that deserves a huge applause. When I invited members of the marching band to come and join Band 8 this evening to do sort of a crossover type celebration for the members of Band 8 hanging into the high school band, I kind of cast out a wide net, hoping that, you know, if I invite a lot, I'll get about half of that. Well, every one of them said yes. And yeah. It really is a testimony to the way they feel about being members of one of the best high school band programs, and certainly the Pride of Princeton Marching Band, in the city, in the state. So very proud of this. We are going to, and in that spirit of marching band, which will be that'll be the next group that these kids interact with in July, we are going to welcome to the stage our many members of the Pride of Princeton drumline back here. Give them a big round. We're going to give you just a little taste of the halftime show. I believe it's called British Invasion. And for any of you Beatles fans out there, I want to hold your hand. Thank you.
All right, this is our final group of the evening. This is Zero Bell Concert Band. And this group meets every morning at 7 a.m. and we rehearse until 7:50, and then they continue on with their normal middle school day. And it is truly a pleasure to teach these students. They come in, they work hard, and they do a fabulous job. And I was just trying to tell the eighth graders before we came out here, it's kind of weird. It's kind of weird that it's the last concert. I've been with them since sixth grade, and this is our final concert on stage together. However, it's not the end, because I think my job is one of the coolest jobs there is, in the fact that not only I get to make music with these kids every day, but I also get to see them start in sixth grade and go all the way through their senior year of high school. So it's not goodbye. I will see you all again next year in the high school marching band. But it's been a true pleasure to work with them, and I thank you all for your support, parents, guardians, family members. It's been a crazy ride through COVID and everything else, but they've really done a nice job. And then, as I told the seventh graders, they're stuck with me for another year, so it is what it is, guys. No, they've done a wonderful job. We're going to perform three pieces for you tonight. The first one is called Capstone March. We performed this on Friday for judges for Music in the Parks. And then they're going to perform a piece called In the Valley, which will be conducted by Mr. Funky. And then we'll close out. We will close out this evening's portion of the concert with New Era Fanfare, which we also performed for judges on Friday night. And just a special shout out to these guys. They performed Friday evening, like I said, in front of judges, and they received a superior rating, which is the highest rating a band can receive. So let's give them a round of applause for that. So without further ado, this is Capstone March. Thank you. right, before we do our final piece, we have a few announcements. Starting in 1961, with the award of 2 scholarships, the Princeton Music Boosters have supported the musical growth of hundreds of Princeton music students through the subsidy of private lesson expenses. Although private study is not required for participation in the Princeton Music Program, it is well understood that advanced musical achievement requires this level of instruction. The awarding of scholarships to talented and dedicated music students not only encourages their growth, but also has a direct impact on the quality of the overall music curriculum. Scholarship applications are typically available in March of each year and awarded in April of each year for the following school year. This year, we would like to recognize the following Princeton Music Booster Scholarship recipients. When I call your name, please come up front. We'll give you a certificate, and then I'm going to have you stand up in front so we can get a large group picture. Up first, the Princeton Music Boosters Dr. Irving Presley McPhail Private Lesson Scholarship is awarded to Austin Young for saxophone lessons. The Princeton Music Boosters David J. Maroon Private Lesson Scholarship is awarded to Axel Ruiz Mondragon for French horn lessons for the 23-24 school year. The Princeton Music Boosters Becky Brown Private Lesson Scholarship is awarded to Aaron Schutte for oboe lessons. The Princeton Music Boosters Johnny L. Williams Memorial Scholarship is awarded to Sergio Ventura for saxophone lessons. The Princeton Music Boosters George Parsley Private Lesson Scholarship is awarded to Travis Anglin for clarinet lessons. The Princeton Music Boosters P.H. Weinert Memorial Private Lesson Scholarship is awarded to Yemi Telez for clarinet lessons. Princeton Music Boosters Private Lesson Scholarship awarded to Quinn Baker for saxophone lessons. The Princeton Music Boosters Thomas S. Benjamin Memorial Scholarship is awarded to Audit Chimplonker for percussion lessons. The Princeton Music Boosters Tom and Karen Benjamin Family Private Lesson Scholarship is awarded to Anthony Vasquez Lopez for clarinet lessons. The Princeton Music Boosters Larry Mraz Private Lesson Scholarship is awarded to Consuela Jimenez for trumpet lessons. And the Princeton Music Boosters Private Lesson Scholarship is awarded to Matthew Gentle for bassoon lessons. Hang on for 1 second. Mrs. Brown is down in front. She's going to take your picture. Say cheese. And as they're getting seated, just a little bit of info on our final piece, New Era Fanfare. This piece has a different aspect to it in that there is a synthesizer that is going to be played, and that is not typical in concert band music, but it is a new era. And so we are going to invite Samantha Young, who is going to perform on the synthesizer for New Era Fanfare.